An improving inventory picture is going to help Mattel, in the view of my next guest, Jeff Blazer, analyst at Morgan Joseph and an expert in the toy business. Good to have you with us, Jeff.
Thank you very much. Great to be here.
Let's talk about the Mattel results. A lot of cost-cutting, pullbacks on advertising, this all part of their program. But can you cut your way to prosperity with Mattel?
Absolutely. I think the cost-cutting was certainly a portion of the rally today. Not too often that you see a 5 to 7% gain when sales are down 20%. But I think a lot of investors are looking at 2010. It's primed for a very big year for Mattel. And this was the toughest comparison that the company had this year, in my opinion. And with this out of the way, with inventories, as you mentioned, at the retail improving from quarter to quarter, destocking appearing to be nearing the end, things are setting up for, improvements in the second half. And as I mentioned, a very strong 2010.
Talk about the Barbie franchise right now. 50th anniversary of Barbie for Mattel. You've got a buy rating on the stock. How much of that is banking on Barbie?
Oh, Barbie, I think, not a huge amount. We're expecting the Barbie declines. Barbie has been declining over the last 5 to 7 years. We expect that to minimize going forward. Certainly, it's doing quite well domestically. I think up 6% in the first half of the year based on the 50th anniversary. Internationally, all products are struggling. I think Europe is doing worse, having worse economic issues than the United States. So that continues to be an issue. But I think they're going back to their core focus on Barbie, getting more current, more cultural, back to what was positive for Barbie in the 1990s and early 2000s, and that certainly should pay dividends in addition to a lot of the positive publicity they've received with their 50th anniversary.
Talk, if you can, about the Hot Wheels business of Mattel. That's a lower margin business?
Yes, lower margin business, doing, particularly domestically better than the rest. If you think about it, lower priced products is kind of the focus, particularly in a recessionary environment, and that works in well with Hot Wheels. You get a car for a few bucks here or there, and a lot of the products are under 20, so it's certainly an ideal product line in a tough economic environment.
Jeff Blazer, is it too early to look at Christmas 2009 for any kind of signal as to the health of the toy business?
It's never too early, considering majority of their sales are based in the holiday season. I certainly think we're coming. We're probably not going to have a gangbuster second half. We'll probably have a third difficult holiday season in a row. But I think things should improve from last year and the year before. We're looking for improvements in the third quarter, down about 7%, 7-8%. In sales, slight increase in the fourth quarter, particularly with the strengthening of the dollar last year. The comparisons get a lot easier in the fourth quarter, so where you see about a 5-6% decline in sales based off of currency exchange, it starts to lighten up in the back half of the year, and that should certainly give some positive information as well.
All right, now you've got a buy rating on the shares of Mattel. The price target still $20 a share. Stock closing at what, $17.44 today? You still like the stock?
I still like the stock. You also have about a 4-5% dividend on top of that. And like I said, one of the major hurdles is out of the way. The second quarter, a lot of concern over whether or not they'd be able to hit the earnings number. And even with the challenges we're having this year, I like to say Mattel is having a cash flow story in 2000 and then a toy story in 2010. We expect a free cash flow yield of about 9% this year, even with the difficult economy. And then next year they're adding two key licenses, WWE, Thomas and Friends, and you also have Toy Story 3 coming out, which they also have the license for, which has historically been a very powerful brand, particularly on the toy side. So certainly some positive movements outside of the cost cutting for 2010 as well.
Jeff, I'm glad you mentioned a movie there, Toy Story. Talk now about IMAX, another company, and the effect of Transformers on IMAX. What did you take away from the weekend open?
Oh, the weekend open was phenomenal. It was a little bit better than I anticipated, although I was expecting strong numbers, over $100 million in gross box office. I think what it really did for IMAX was bring it in the visibility of the investment community. The real story is the growth of its theater base, the profitability within the three segments of their business. They get 12.5% of all gross box office generated within an IMAX theater. They have currently have 250 theaters up and running. They have backlog of, as of the end of Q1, of about 190. And as those theaters start to mount up, that 12.5% on that one particular area of their business can add up for some pretty good profit margins.
All right, I want to thank you very much, Jeff Blazer. Unfortunately, we're coming to the end of that film. He's got a buy rating on the shares of IMAX, a $9 price target, the stock closing at $8.14 today.